Stay here, find some place to hide. Don't come out until I say so, okay?
Yeah, okay. Men coming!
Right, you sons of bitches, let's get this started.
He's gonna run, kill him!
Lisa? Kid? Come on out, it's safe.
Topping off. You okay?
Yeah. I think I want to go home.
Nah, kid, the camp. You'll be safe there, you'll see.
Okay.
I'm gonna ask you a question, Lisa, and I need you to think real hard. Did any of your neighbors... did they own any firearms, you know, like pistols, rifles, things like that?
No. Men came and took everything.
Men? Were they like the men in the tunnel, or did they wear uniforms like in the army?
Like the army. But they were really dirty, and they carried flags they made themselves. Deschutes County Militia, I think. I don't remember.
Did they have anyone with them? Women? Children?
I don't remember.
Okay.
Tommy would remember.
Tommy?
Tommy Strickland. My best friend. But he's gone. He left with his dad to hide.
Hide? I don't...
His dad built a fallout shelter and put all kinds of stuff in it. Maps, food, water, guns, you know. Stuff like that.
Okay, do you know where that is?
No. They wanted me to come with them, but I knew my mom and dad would come back for me.
Hey. Here.
All right, this is it. We're here,
open
so just
gate.
Stay with
it.
Me.
Okay.
Well, who do we have here?
Mrs. Tucker.
Oh, my God. Lisa, honey. Oh, it's okay. You're safe now.
Mom and Dad, and everyone got sick, and I didn't know what to do, and men came, and people got sick, and...
It's okay. You're safe now. It's a miracle. It's a goddamn miracle. We were neighbors, weren't we, Lisa? I lived just down the block. I knew her parents.
Are they here, Mrs. Tucker?
Honey, you know the answer to that.
No. They're not here.
Let's go in. Get you cleaned up. Something to eat, and then I'll find a place for you to sleep. Take her in. Give her some food. Go see Alkai. I'll update your credits tonight.
Hey, listen. She's been through a lot. Can we just...
Let me worry about how...
No, listen to me, okay? Seriously, don't work her like you do everyone else.
Don't tell me how to run my camp. You want to move here? You want to help us run this? Then maybe you get some say. Don't get soft on me, Dee.
How's it going?
What?
Okay.
You need something? Thanks. What else can I do for you? Can I get anything else for you? This'll do you good out there. Here you go. Find me if you need anything else. I'll let Tucker know you stopped by. You here for your bike?
Hey, just taking a look.
Stuff's getting scarce. Bike's looking busted up. Check back. See you around.
Wait a sec, I got it.
Come on.
just caught a break. That narrow radio over there is not useful. I know where they're going tomorrow.
Wait, I thought you said you couldn't take them on.
No, I can't. But with a little luck, I can get to the chopper without being seen and...
Give them hell, brother. Remember what Jack used to say? Don't ride faster than your guardian angel can fly.
Like I said, Jack used to say a lot of stupid shit. Deacon out. Let's go see what the hell Nero is up to.
O'Brien,
get some questions for you.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Back during the American Revolution, we were fighting for our freedoms. We gained the beautiful right to keep and bear arms. Right we use to protect ourselves, our families, our property. That is, until the ever-growing federal government got scared of the people they swore to protect. Over the years, they stripped us of every gun line they could, using a few mass shootings as an excuse to curtail the God-given rights of us, American citizens. Gun control. And there went the Second Amendment, ladies and gentlemen. Let me ask you this. This shit went down. If every American was packing up, do you think we'd be in this mess? Hell no. This is how the feds wanted it. Disarming the public was just the first step toward getting rid of us all.
This infestation zone.
So who do those gun laws really protect? Sure as hell wasn't us, the American taxpayers. Someday, we ever dig out of this?
Come back later. Finish burning up these nests.
I bet those who survived. Those who had guns. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, Cope, this time you got me. I'll take all the guns I can get my hands on. Ain't no one taking them away from me.
So, you want to learn how to hunt? Is that what I'm hearing?
I know how to shoot a gun.
It's a rifle, not a gun.
I was in the 10th Mountain, Cope. Don't give me any of your Marine Corps bullshit.
Killing a buck's a little different than killing a man. Or a freak. The best way to hunt an animal is to track it. You gotta focus. And see what nature's trying to tell you. If you look hard enough, you'll see the signs.
Okay, then. Look hard. See this pile of deer scat? It's fresh. Yeah, I see it. They
They lead this way.
Yeah, I can see that.
Well, come on, man. Quick, there's your buck.
I see him.
Now here, use my rifle. If you were in the 10th mountain, you know how to use a scope.
Yeah, Cope, I know how to use a scope.
Easy, easy.
I got this.
Got him. Nice shot.
Oh, goddammit, it wasn't a kill shot. He got away.
Oh, no, that's okay. You wounded him. He'll bleed out soon enough. You just gotta trap him.
Okay.
See the blood spot? Look close.
Yeah, I see him.
Follow him.
On it.
He'll be slowing down about now. Losing too much blood. We should be coming across his carcass anytime now. Okay. You know how to gut an animal?
Yeah, look. Cope, Boozer, and I have been hunting before. He used to go elk hunting with his old man, and yeah, he showed me how to gut a deer.
Well, let's just say, no disrespect to Boozer, but you got a lot to learn. You're wasting a lot of meat there. Overall, not bad for a beginner.
Yeah, thanks.
Now, I'll take back that rifle.
Here, thanks.
Like I said, Deke, we can always use more venison at the camp. Still got some folks trying to heal up from that Ripper attack.
Okay, Cope. Yeah, I'll see if I can remember that.
Hold on, I'll get... the gate.
You, need something, man?
Hey, Manny.
Need fuel? Bike's probably thirsty. Good choice, man. Good choice. This should last you for a while. Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. Wrap that up for you. Cool. Need anything else? I'll be here. All right. Be seeing you.
You know, from before.
Hey.
Like sad,
Damon.
Happy and shit. But like a bunch of Alzheimer's patients. Only pissed off.
What? Not enough credits?
You want to tear your guts out.
I'll be here if you need anything.
How's it going, Booze Man?
I'm fine, goddammit. Hey, Deke, we're getting low on supplies. Use some more meat if you get a chance.
shit. Okay. Guess it's been a while since we did any hunt. I'll see if I can scare up some meat while I'm out.
Remember what you're doing?
Yeah, I had Cope give me a few pointers. See you, Boot Man. Alright, now I'm just gonna find some deer, bear, wolf.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Broke another goddamn razor this morning. In our supposed global utopia, instead of getting the best products from around the world, we got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the new this and that. All of crass commercialism.
That's it.
You want something built to last? You couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country, they'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. Neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope.
But hey, whatever you say.
Yeah, nothing wrong with a little crass commercialism.
I mean, I could use a new bike right about now.
Sarge, how about we make an unscheduled stop on our way back? A couple of sample traps I want to check.
Hey, Doc, how long before your job's done?
Check the larger muscle masses.
Well, look at it this way, you poor son of a bitch. At least you weren't torn apart by freaks. If you lived a few more weeks, you might have become one yourself. Now, whether that been something. What do you want? Stay back.
I just want to talk.
Nero, Protocol 2-7 states clearly that if conducting operations in quarantine zones, that if I encounter any civilians or civilians, that I'm forbidden from making contact.
Really? See, that sounded to me like making contact.
Yes. Yes, it did.
You're alive.
Yes. I am.
How? How are you alive,
O'Brien? What? I don't understand.
Okay. You were there. That night. Farewell. The next night,
Nero Protocol 2-7 states.
Everyone was dead. They were slaughtered. Torn limb for goddamn limb. All right, listen up. We're going to do this the easy way or the hard way. The easy way, we have a little chat. You give me the information that I need, and then you go back to digging your way through freaker shit or whatever the hell else you're doing out here. The hard way. Crack open that little space suit, and then we see what your friends out there have to say about you breathing in all this contaminated air. So what's it gonna be, O'Brien?
Yes. Okay. Okay.
You remember the rooftop of the old brewery? I put a woman on your chopper. She was wounded.
Yes. I remember, a knife wound. She was cut pretty bad.
I went to the refugee camp that you said you were taking her to. Everyone was dead, so I'm gonna ask you again. How did you survive?
We weren't there. We were diverted south to another camp. Like you said, the camp in Belknap was overrun, so they moved us south to a camp outside of Silver Lake.
Were there survivors?
You mean now? I don't know. I was transferred to the research unit.
Did she survive?
Oh, wait. I can find out. I can check. You have one of our radios. That's how you... I can't promise anything, but I'll check.
Uh-huh, and I'm gonna go with you.
No, you can't. Please, you don't... Hey, don't understand. I'll fucking shoot you.
Not before I shoot you.
Okay, look, if you're gonna fucking kill me, do it, okay? I did my job. Did that woman, your wife... I put her on oxygen, I gave her an IV. I kept her alive. I got in a lot of trouble for that. She was septic, she wasn't gonna make it, but I got her to the mass unit. I saved her goddamn life!
O'Brien, report.
I have to go. Please, you have to get out of here. You don't know these men. You don't know
O'Brien,
what they're capable of.
If I don't hear from you, I don't care how long it takes, I'm gonna track you down. And I'm gonna do a lot worse than snap off an antenna.
I'm sorry about your wife. But you're not the only one who lost someone that night.
Man,
A few days ago, I asked you if you remembered that Nero asshole, O'Brien.
Yeah, Deke, it's all kind of a blur.
Yeah, okay. Get some shut-eye, booze man. I'll tell you about it later.
When are we riding out of here, Deke?
Soon, Boozer.
Man, we're coming!
Soon. Soon. As soon as your arm heals, we're gonna be riding the hell out of here.
Yeah, Deke. Okay.
You, out there, hide.
Something's here.
We got food, beer, whiskey. We got ammo, too. You join us.
O'Brien.
Pick you up. What do you say?
You out there, O'Brien? Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? You're on this channel. God damn it.
Come on!
Lay it into him!
You gotta stop moving sometime!
Do it, running around like that.
Oh, you son of a bitch, you better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? If you're on this channel, god damn it. You better radio me. You hear me, O'Brien? You're on this channel. God damn it. You better get back to me or I'm going to track you down. You got that? Oh, god damn it. Oh, come on!
Ryan!
Get back to me.
Now I get that.
Chopper. Was it the same guy, the one we saw on the roof that night?
Yeah, it was him.
And did he remember us? Sarah, what happened?
I don't know. They got diverted south. He remembered her, but he doesn't know what happened to her.
You don't think she's still alive?
What? No. I mean, no. Look, I'm not stupid, Boozer. I just want to find out, you know, what happened to her, where she died. I don't need to find any peace, Jesus. I gotta go, all right? Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. I grew up in these here woods. My grandfather taught me all about hunting. Funny how it still works in a world he never would have dreamed of. I built my first treehouse to use as a deer blind. Getting height on your target helps your aim and keeps you safe. Back then, I took out my first doe from up top. Today, my camp's up in the trees. You want to survive and can contribute, you come to me. We got you covered. Grandfather also taught me to catch a doe. Sometimes you gotta lay an ambush. You're as likely to be prey as hunter. So you gotta keep your eyes peeled when you're heading to places we all need to go. But grandfather always said the easiest way to a good meal was to lay a trap. Put a snare by a tree, and you could have dinner next time you come around. But careful. A headless
snake can still bite. Especially when it ain't really dead. My grandfather would have outlived us all. Let me tell you. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Great, Cope! So you and your granddaddy set traps for him, and you and your old man used to lay down salt licks. That's real sporting.
Guess none of that shit matters now.
Shit, sorry, I didn't mean to be gone that long.
It's getting dark soon.
We'll be okay. Hey, booze man, I brought in some meat. Should keep us stocked up for a while.
Hey, Deke, thanks, man. I'm not real hungry right now. I'll salt it up in a bit.
Gotta close my eyes for a bit. I'm ready to go back at it. Thank you.
is it? God damn, that's gotta be close.
Yeah. Now.
On the road, damn it. Ambushing you. I'll take that. I can fix this. That's it. It doesn't look too bad.
One of the drifters, let him in.
Hey, you keep him busy?
You got
some bounties out there.
How's it going?
How you doing, kid?
They won't let me leave.
Why would you want to leave? It's safe here.
I have to work.
Okay.